Strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. But if a man live many years, and rejoice in them all, yet let him remember the days of darkness, for they shall be many. Rejoice, O young man, in thy youth, and let thine heart cheer thee in the days of thy youth. And walk in the ways of thine heart, and in the sight of thine eyes. But know thou that for all these things God will bring thee into judgment. Therefore, Remove sorrow from thy heart, and put away evil from thy flesh. For childhood and youth are vanity. Thus said the word of the Lord. That's when we look at life and we sum up life. We are here today, gone tomorrow. But the writer said, it's appointed unto man once to die, but after that comes the judgment. So we have to prepare ourselves. Thanks be to God that we are here today to thank the Lord for the privilege of life, and we can celebrate. All glory, dominion, power belongs to Him. May I take this opportunity to extend sincere condolences on behalf of my family and the wider church family to the family of the late Neville Brown. We know it's not easy to go through this period, but one thing we are sure of is that the Lord shall be with us to comfort and keep you as you go through. So be blessed and be encouraged of the Lord. We're going to begin this afternoon by, or this morning, don't know if it's reached 12 yet, with the opening hymn, How Great Thou Art. May I invite you to stand as we sing this together. Consider all the words that I Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Oh, great is our God and greatly to be praised. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Remain standing at this time as I invite Sister Walford to come forward and do the opening prayer. That's the sister of the deceased.
Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we approach a mercy seat one more time, Lord. We bless you, praise, we lift up your name this morning. Thank God for your loving kindness and your tender mercy this morning. The writer reminds, oh great the Lord this morning. And as we come this morning to put away a loved one, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We shall get one card here this morning. Oh God, we pray that peace will be among us this morning. God, we pray to bless every item, oh God, on this program this morning. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we're here to lift up your name in the name of Jesus. Be with us, Lord. Everything done to honor your glory. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Thank you very much. You may be seated. As we come to share today, I trust that the presence of the Lord shall be with us as we continue through the program. And may I invite and introduce to you Minister Shemaria, who will be moderating the rest of this program as we go throughout this day. Bless the Lord.
Thank you very much, Pastor Smith. I want to use this opportunity this morning to greet our host, Pastor Shemaria. Also want to give my condolences to the bereaved family and friends this morning. I pray your strength as you continue to mourn. I know that the Lord will see you through. He promised in his word that he will comfort those who mourn. And we believe that God is not slack concerning his promise. Whatsoever he said that he's going to do, that will he do. So we pray your strength during this time of bereavement. I continue with our program this morning. Our first lesson will be taken from Philippians chapter 4, reading from verse 4 to 9. This will be done by Peter Gay Brown Meeks. Let's have Peter Gay. Thank you.
Morning, everyone. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and mind through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you.
At this moment, we'll be having a song, and this will be done by Kianjo Moncrief, niece in law, followed by a second lesson. This will be done by Belvina Freckleton, sister, taken from Romans 14:7-12. Let's have Kianjo Moncrief, niece in law. Melvina Freckleton, Romans chapter 14:7-12.
For none of us liveth to himself, and no man dieth to himself. For whether we live unto the Lord, and whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ both died and rose and revived, that he might be Lord both of the dead and the living. But why dost thou judge thy brother? Or why dost thou set at naught thy brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat. For it is written, as I live, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. So then, every one of us shall give account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Having open tributes, and this is just as it says, open tributes. So we have four open tributes. So at this moment, I'll be asking these four persons to come along and share their tributes. Am I having the first person? Life is out of hand.
He walks with me, he talks with me, and always morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection, I am the life. Whoever believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live, and he shall have everlasting life. Neville, affectionately known as Coco, is my favorite uncle. He's my brother, he's also my father. From childhood to adulthood, he was the backbone of the family. He was a provider. Neville spent most of his years traveling to and from the US, working as a farm worker. Every year we would look forward to Neville going to and from, and he would bring us the best of things. Unfortunately, Neville became very ill for a very short time. He was hospitalized. On his way to the CAT scan, Neville promised us, he said, he would be all right. He said when he comes back, he will talk to us. Unfortunately, he didn't get that chance. Everything was so fast. Neville, you left us wondering. You said you would be back. You said you would talk to us. And you never returned. But the God of heaven, he knows best. He took you for a very special reason. The family is here grieving our loss. We are unhappy, we are sad, but we know God have you where he's supposed to have you. And we are praying that you will enjoy the everlasting life that God has promised you. We love you very much and we miss you, and there will always be a special place in our heart for us. Thank you very much.
So one more, is there another you'd like to share? If not,
good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
To the pastors and the podium, Chivalry and Pastor Sinners. I want to say to the Brown family, you have our sympathy this morning, my personal family and my church family. I could not sit there and be the prompt to say anything. Since I came to Claremont in 1983 to the bit of work, I have known this family. Neville was somebody that I always encourage. One of the outstanding things in my memory is that Neville was a hard worker. And sometimes I would meet him when he's going to his field and I said, Neville, you need to give the Lord a day, just like how you are so faithful to go to the field and work. So I was one of them that always encouraged it. And today, it is sad for all of us, especially for the family. Because when I learned of his passing, as the niece came up and said, it happened so quick. And all of us that are here, some way, never had meant something to us. I want to encourage you before I take my seat that eternal life is promised to all of us. And I don't know if you already made your choice. But today, I want to appeal to you, brothers and sisters, if you have not yet made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, I implore you to do so. I did that over 40 years ago as a young man. From one party to the other, from one night to the other. And if God saved me, he can touch your heart. May the Lord bless you. Thank you very much.
Bless the Lord. It's good to praise the Lord. Can we just lift our hands and praise the Lord? Amen. Amen. The word of the Lord said that the dead cannot praise God. It is only the living who give God the praise. Amen. And while we are alive, we're going to just lift our hands above our heads this morning and just say something to God, because He has been a faithful God. Hallelujah. I know that you're grieving, but in spite of the grief, God is to be praised. Amen. Is that an amen, somebody? Hallelujah. The word of God said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. He is worthy to be praised. I just want to thank you for sharing this morning. I have listened to songs giving words of encouragement. I have listened to words of encouragement by just sharing from your hearts. And we are grateful for you sharing in different ways this morning. At this moment, we'll be having a selection, and this will be done by Sister Marvelyn Brown. Let's have her. After Sister Marvelyn, we'll be having a remembrance, and this will be done by the V. Jefferson needs. Let's have them.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Life has been so good, I can't complain. When I ask,
for me, while
Indeed, heaven will be sounding sweeter all the time. Thank you, Sister Brown, for reading this song. I hope and trust that this will be a sounding message to all of us, that there is a better place for the saints of God. Remembrance, and we're going to have that remembrance by Vivian Jefferson.
Cynthia,
answer.
This remembrance is from Cynthia Brown, but she was unable to come. So my name is Arjun, I'm one of the deans, so I'm just going to read it for her. Neville, memories of my brother Neville, fondly called Tata. By the family, he was exceptional. My brother was very kind, considerate, jovial, pleasant, and generous. It was a blessing when he began to travel to the United States of America. As a farm worker, this he did for several years, from as back as early 70s. As children, we would look forward with great anticipation his homecoming on each trip. I recalled him coming home from the state. Oh boy, those were happy days, especially when he was with the suitcase taken to the house. Of course, we were not allowed to touch anything, as our mother put them in her room for safekeeping. However, when the suitcase were opened, of us were given our goodies, which we were all satisfied with. He was a good shopper. I can't express how I'm feeling, even now, knowing that I will never see or hear his voice. Whenever I spoke with him on the telephone, he always said, "Aunt, walk on. Give thanks, man. You're good? Give thanks." He will always be remembered as a special place in my heart. God, may his soul rest in peace.
Thank you very much for sharing. No wonder the Bible said that our life is a tale. Amen? Our life is a story. And this is simply saying to us that while we are alive, then we should live a good life. So after death, somebody will be able to take something out of our bones. Amen? Bless the Lord. I encourage us to live a good life while you are alive. And I want to say to you, the best life to live while you're alive is to accept Jesus in your life and allow him to direct your path. May the Lord continue to bless you. At this moment, we'll be collecting an offering. And if you notice, it's in aid of our church building fund.
I know that my Redeemer is in me. I know that my Redeemer is in me. strength of my force. My head of glass, with oil and oil, and my cup overflows.
Yeah. And we look and see
what life is, the thought in her mind, what is it that I can say that will bring such an impact on somebody today that such a one would be willing to just turn their lives around and come to accept the word of God. You see, no matter how we prepare, when we come face to face with the reality of death, then something happens in the inner man. Something happens to us when we look at this final stage of a man's life upon this earth. He was here a few days ago, but today he is no longer here with us. We are here today, but we do not know about tomorrow. It's just promised to us. May I say to us today that it is today, it is what we do today, it is how we live today that is going to determine our tomorrow. And somebody might say, but if I die, it doesn't matter, I will not know. But the Bible says to us, it's appointed unto man once to die. But after death, there is an after death. After death comes the judgment. There will be a time when we will have to give an account for our today. Are we preparing ourselves for such a time? Because such a time will certainly come. Hallelujah. And so it behooves us today, my friends, that while we yet live, let us prepare ourselves. Life is when we get up this morning and realize that we have not done this by ourselves and could not have done this by ourselves, no matter how we wanted to. But it is God that raises us up this morning. Hallelujah. It is God who is keeping us through the day. It is God whom we are depending on to carry us all the way. It's not by power or by might, but it is by the Spirit of Almighty God. Amen. So all I want for us today to do is take an introspection of self. My brother has lived his life. Whatsoever he did, if he do it not well, then sin lies at his door. So each and every one of us in here today will be recompensed. Will be recompensed. Will be rewarded according to the works that we have done while we yet live.
Amen.
So all this show off and pride and self and exalting ourselves, forget it. Forget it. It doesn't help, my brother, no.
can help us on the line in our core bread. What will help us is how well we have done while we yet live. The Bible said your work shall follow. Your work shall follow you. Glory to God, your work shall follow you. So I want to encourage us today. You know, one of my mantras is that every day is a new beginning. Every day is a new chapter in my life. I can't affect yesterday. But today, I can choose to do the things that I need to do according to the will of God. So every day, I can turn my life over. It doesn't matter what sins or whatsoever it is that happened to you yesterday. Oh, the grace and love of God has brought you from that time into this time right now. Where we can look into ourselves and say, after all, I must serve the Lord. After all, I must look into my life. I must look into my situation. You know, there was a famous song in my young boy days, and I know it before me. This song, because I came and heard it say, what am I living for? Is not for you. My God Almighty, what am I living for? It's not for Jesus. Who should we be living for? What about the person that wakes us up this morning? What about the person who has our lives in his hands? What about the person that can build up and tear down? What about the person? Let me tell you something. I look on the accident down in London the other day. And these people are going about their business quite comfortable, quite all right, probably having a nice time. But all of a sudden, the Bible said that the devil is at our heels, seeking to devour and to destroy. And when we least know it not, that's when something happens. When you look, people are strewn all over the road, lying down, broken up, dead. Did not even have time to say, Lord, have mercy. You know, they will walk away, having been revived. They will walk away, not even thinking about the fact that I could have died. And my soul lost, without hope, without God. What will our answer be? We stand here, sit here today. We're thinking about his life. But may I say, with all respect to the family members, and I mourn and grieve with you, but his life is with the Lord. The Lord has control of wheresoever he ought to be. That's right. What is important now? What does his life mean to us? His life before us today is an example that we do not live forever. That sooner or later, our time will come. We are on the stratum of life. Will we be? Do you hear the psalm say, well done, our blow away. Prepare for the devil and his angels. I will be here. Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into my Father's everlasting rest. I posit to you today, my friends, that the best thing that we can do, the only thing that we have to do in life, is to live for God. Live for God. And we live for God by keeping his word, by keeping his command, by following that which he has laid on for us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I pray today that somebody having left from here will leave with a deeper understanding that life without Christ is no life at all. If I know my Bible well, if I know my Bible well, I do believe, Pastor, that this part of a man's life is the shortest path. Three score and ten, by reason of strength, four score and some a little more. But when we talk about life after death, we're talking about eternity. Yeah. Yeah. We're talking about never-ending life. Whether in hell or in heaven. Whether with Jesus or with the devil and his angels. There's a little thought that says, I hope I get it right, that I'd rather serve God now. I'd rather serve God now. And after I die on that day, I find out that there is no heaven to give. Than not to serve God now. And when I reach, I find out that yes, there is a heaven. Can I say to you, brethren, don't take chance with your life. Don't take chance with your life. You have, the Bible said, have you not seen? Have you not heard? We are in the world too long now to not see the goodness of God. To have not seen the plans of the enemy. Not to take heed to the things of God. The word has been preached over and over, and we have seen the results. And we can say, as the scripture says, my friends, we have two choices, two roads before you. One leads to eternal life, one leads eternal damnation. Jesus said, choose life. Because there's a path that seemeth right unto a man. And this is a problem with the world today. We are seeing things only to our eyes and not trusting God enough to carry us through. There's a path that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is death. And we don't have to even guess this, we see it in front of our eyes. The end of it is death. But there's another part, a straight and narrow part, a part without war. A part without hypocrisy. A part without fighting. A part of love and brotherliness or brotherhood. A part where we experience the peace of Almighty God even in the midst of the storm. And I say to us today, choose that part. It is a part to your eternal life. It's a righteous part to your eternal home. And so as we come together today and we celebrate this life, we want to remember that we are here and we have a life to live. Why not live it for the Lord? You know, the thought that I close on is the fact that from the book of Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 4, the scripture says to us, verse 1, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead, and his appearing and his kingdom. God shall judge the quick and the dead. If we keep that in remembrance, that a time will be coming when we shall stand before the great judgment, and we will have to give an account for the deeds that we have done. But the verse that I want to leave with you and I want to get to is verse 7 and 8. Very long verse. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing, or appearance. You know, the scripture told us that when men and earth have done their best, not even the angels in heaven can do better. And this is, you can't fool yourself, and you can't fool God. Yeah. Amen. And while we live this life, my friends, while we yet live this life, if we know that we have fought a good fight, you don't have to get certification from anyone. You know within yourself that you have done the best that you could according to the will of God. You see here in the scripture, Paul had finished all that he had to do. And the last thing here was to give instruction to the young man, the young minister, Timothy. Amen. I remember the story well. There are so many times when he was told not to go to certain places because he would have died. Lastly, was in Rome. But having done all that he had to do, he came to the point where death did not even matter to him anymore. Because he knew within himself that he had accomplished all that he had to do in the service of the Lord. And so he could boldly say in the scripture that I have fought a good fight. He didn't ask anybody to verify this. He knew within himself that he had done all he could do. He had kept the faith. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Somebody will accept the Lord as their personal savior. Somebody will cry out spirit. These are dead today. Hallelujah. And if there's somebody in the congregation who have not yet made a decision for the Lord, this is a time, a place, an opportunity to say, yes, Lord, even me. Pour out of your spirit in me today. As I close, Bible reminds us that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. How can they hear without a preacher? How can they preach without he be sent? Certainly, God has sent this word for somebody today, for us all today. And I encourage you to receive it in the name of Jesus. Right where you are today, is there somebody in the congregation who would say, yes, pray with me, Pastor. I'll receive that word. You're here and not saved. Is there somebody today, before I leave this podium, I can come this.
Can we worship the Lord again?
Yes, Lord.
Okay, we are grateful to God today, and we are thankful also to Pastor Smith for making himself available to be used by the Lord this afternoon to bring us such a word. And we are encouraged by the word of the Lord through the servants of God today that we ought to examine ourselves to see whether or not we are in the faith. And as we leave here this afternoon, let not these words slip, but let them be on the table of your hearts as you seek to examine yourself. For tomorrow is not promised to any man, but today is the day of salvation. For those of us who are children of God, let us examine ourselves to see if Christ should come now, if we will be ready. God bless you all. God keep you. At this moment, we'll be having a eulogy, and this will be done by Miss Beverly White. Family friend.
For my brother. Looking around the room today, I see many familiar faces, as well as new ones. This isn't surprising to me, for Brother Neville has always been a friendly, jovial, and outgoing person. He never met a stranger. Everyone always immediately was a potential new friend. It makes this much easier and interesting. His famous words were always, "Give thanks, man, give thanks." Our brother Neville was born on the 3rd of February, 1947, from a family of 9 siblings, that is, 3 brothers and 6 sisters. He attended the Claremont Elementary School, otherwise known as Homeside. As a young man grown up, he worked as an apprentice, learning trade with Mr. Ken Mitchell in building construction. However, his big break came in 1974 when he started traveling on the farm work program to the United States of America. He traveled for several years to the state as a farm worker and was given a temporary visa. He also went for a short period in the Canadian Farm Work Program. On his return home from these trips, everybody could expect some sort of goodies from him. He always ensures that his family was well taken care of. Our brother Neville was a champion. He met and married the love of his life, Daphne, otherwise known as Tiny, on the 19th of June, 1991. The union produced 2 children, Naisha and Danica, otherwise called Tundra. Neville became very ill in the early part of May and was taken to the St. Anne's Bay Hospital, and after spending 2 weeks there, he was discharged. However, he was rushed back to the hospital as his condition became worse. He was again admitted on the 29th day of May, 2022. While there, he succumbed to his illness on the 10th day of June, 2022. His daughter, Nahisha, should be commended for the tremendous job in taking care of him to the very last end. Could his daughter stand, please? Let me acknowledge you. Say amen for her.
Amen.
We will be greatly missed by all of us. Thank you all for supporting us through this such a difficult loss. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
This afternoon, for those of us who weren't acquainted with Mr. Brown, we get to know some more about him. Thank you very much for this information about his life while he was alive. At this moment, I'll be asking Pastor Shemaria to be praying for the family. I'll be asking the Reed family to be seated and those the others who are not a member of the family to stand. So I'm going to ask the bereaved family remain seated while the rest of one of the members of the family to just stand while Pastor Shemaria will be praying for the bereaved family.
Honor your name above all. As you glorify you, Lord, as God. We thank you, God, according to your word, that in everything we should give you thanks. Because you know the beginning from the end. Lord, you know what is going to come with you. So we want to thank you this afternoon, Lord, and to honor your name for this time, God, that we can gather like this. Even though it's a sad moment, Lord, it gives us the opportunity to reflect, the opportunity, Lord, to look into our own lives and to do our own personal review. And God, we also thank you for that. I pray at this time, Lord, that you will be with this family. I pray that you will be their comfort, that you will ease their pain. I pray, God, that you will fill the vacuum that is left behind. Oh God, by this father, brother, and relative. I ask God that you will bless this family with peace. Lord God, I pray that you will supply their need. I know God that they have spent, and in some cases might have spent, God. But I ask Lord God that you will refill, God, what is spent, that you will bless them, God, with resources. God, even from unsuspected sources, these blessings will come. I ask, Father God, that this will be a lesson to the family. Lord God, like the preacher says, that we are not here forever. And that, God, this lesson will be taken seriously. I pray, God, that coming out of this, somebody will say, I am going to serve the Lord. I pray, Father God, that you will be among the family, that you will bless those who travel from far to be here. And I ask, Lord God, that you will bless them even on their trip going back. I ask, Father, for coverage. Oh God, I pray for those, Lord, who will take the mantle after Mr. Neville. Oh God, that you will bless them alike. For, Lord, it is said, Father, that he was leader, breadwinner in some cases, Lord, at sometimes back. And I pray, God, that this vacuum will be filled, that they will never be left comfortless, Lord, but that you will comfort them. We pray your blessing upon them right now. Holy Father, give them peace, give them joy. And I ask, Lord, that they are hoping you will be revived. We thank you for your prayer and their behalf and blessing them today. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Chevrolet. We have a recession of him. We will be in the program. You can see there's a land.
Hallelujah! Jubilee!
Okay. Can I go ahead? Yeah, I was looking to think my aunt would be here, but she's the one with the death certificate and all of that.
No, I have that.
You have it? Oh, okay.
I mean, who up need?
Okay. Again.
No.
I go up in here again. Open here again.
Well done, Delapena. Well done.
He's blue.
He doesn't look different.
Doesn't look different. He's the same. I see him never. I see him once. He's the same. Don't come down here, no daddy, no re, no nobody. Bye, idiots. Freddy cat.
Freddy
cat. Freddy cat, re.
Come down. All right, everybody. We are about to commit this body. So please give me your attention.
Right.
The Bible declares that all flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another flesh other of fishes, and other of birds. There are also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial, but the glory of the celestial is one and the glory of the terrestrial is another. There is one glory of the sun and another glory of the moon and another glory of the stars, for one star differeth from another star in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There's a natural body and there's a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man Adam was made a living soul, the last Adam was made a quickening spirit. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doeth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall all be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. As we lay aside this body today, we have a hope of eternal life, that those who died in Christ Jesus, we know that one day, we shall rise triumphantly to see our King. We can bless the name of the Lord. We can sign. The soul of man is eternal, but his flesh shall perish and return to the dust. His ears are few here, for he cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He pursues life and hopes for longer days and brighter hours. But alas, he that is unjust or he that is righteous, let him be. For no time is left now. The Lord will reward justly. Therefore, we shall now commit to the ground the remain of this temple of clay, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, awaiting the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, and their works do follow them. Bless the name of the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for this moment that we have to share, my God, even as we commit this body to the ground. May his soul rest in peace as we pray for those who grieve and mourn his loss today. You said in your word, all souls are mine. The souls of the Father, the souls of the Son, but the soul that sinneth shall surely die. Father, if we live, we live unto you. If we die unto you. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. We pray that you bless and sanctify this moment for your will and purpose. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Bless the Lord. Will you join with me as the workmen cover up this grave? The hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Will you help me sing this song today? What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a friend. Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Dedicate to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrow share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Dedicate to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden? Cumbered with a load of care. Precious Savior, still a refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do your friends despise, forsake you? Take it to the Lord in prayer. And I'm gonna say goodbye. When my life on earth is ended, I'm gonna say goodbye. I'm gonna say goodbye. Oh, my life on earth is ended. I'm... Come on, one more time. Oh, I'm gonna say goodbye. Oh, I'm gonna say happy in the Lord.
Yeah. there was any wheelbarrow on it.
A lot of people were moving to the
benediction. Now may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit the Comforter, rest, remain, abide with us all, both now and forevermore. Amen and amen. God bless you all. Thanks for sharing. God bless you.
Let me go.
number is it?
776.
What?
C776.
Yeah, keep your number just in case. Somebody can tell you what it is.
Talk your number. Talk your number. Your number.
77. Is it 77 you said?
Yeah.
77.
No, everything.
What?
Repeat it.
Oh, keep the number just 76, just in case we decide to put a headstone on it, we'll need it. That's his daughter, you hear?
Right.